Watch out, there's no car. Let's go in.
Welcome.
Well, I'm so excited.
Okay.
You're so nice and lovely, and I'm so excited to try your
okay.
Pizza.
You are the right place, baby. You are the
Okay. Right? That's true.
I've been tracking down these chilaquiles.
I love the chilaquiles.
We met in the food truck, but I was working and everything. But now we have a day that we could work eat.
Exactly. First met. It was the first week of us trying Ensenada for the first time, us as in my Jared, my fiance, and I.
Yeah.
And I know that you definitely sold us on your brownies. And you were asking a lot of questions about, you know, where to go and what to do in Austin, especially desserts.
I'm so grateful you told me Baked Bear, because every time my mom asked me, hey, what do you want to go for dessert? Baked Bear.
Of course.
And then my mom is like, those are humongous ice cream. I know, right?
Perfect. Just your size.
Yeah.
So I think it's awesome just being able to actually sit down and talk with you, because before, you know, we were eating and you were working.
It was really fun meeting you and telling me advices for my videos, and I'm so happy that I get to make my like Instagram and everything, because mm-hmm. I remember like I just post of me like with my doggy and me painting and everything, but then like I love taking video and I love eating.
Yes.
So when you give me the advice, I'm so grateful that my grandma opened the food truck with my aunt, because I could experience with people and they give me advice about like how having your social media and everything. So I'm so grateful that you give me advice.
Absolutely. And I love that you're so passionate about it and at such a young age, because I mean, we all eat, right? But some of us just eat to live and some of us live to eat.
Some people eat for Instagram.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm so excited.
What are we eating today?
So we're gonna eat the quesadilla taco, and we're gonna eat some chilaquiles. Some nice chilaquiles, cause I love chilaquiles and I love pasta and I love sushi and I love so much more food.
Where are we?
We are at La Santa Barabacha.
Yes, we are. At Native.
Yeah.
The east side.
So I have a question for you.
Okay.
When you were little, what was your favorite food?
I will say that I didn't have a lot of variety. So I grew up in Florida, but I didn't have a lot of money growing up. So just trying to figure out different things to eat that was exciting. Just, you know, I was younger and then you don't want to eat the same thing all the time, like PB&Js. When I got older, Cuban and Spanish food were my absolute favorite. So arroz con pollo and, you know, Cuban bread and any rice and beans. I mean, all of that. All of those flavors are usually my favorite.
Me, when I was little, like 5 or 6, in Mexico, we always went with my grandma La Bandera de Mexico. So we always went there, and I always told my grandma, please, can we go? And when she took me, okay? So I always got my corn.
Okay.
But can I tell you something sad? When I lose my teeth, because you know how you lose your teeth and you put it under your pillow?
Yeah.
I couldn't eat the corn anymore and stink. So I'm like, give me a little cup. And they're like, okay. And then I went in Austin and then I tried like one of those street corns and it was really good. I'm like, finally, I ate one time in a stick. Because it's been years I have it, because I've been used to eating in a cup.
Right.
And then, like, I've been used to eating in the cup, so now I ate it with a stick, and I'm like, next time I'm going to do more with a stick. Who pushed you and who made you, like, when you started your blogging, and who gave you the experience, and who gave you the little, like the little compliment you should do and should not do?
So I'd say I've always loved to write. Writing has been such a huge part of my life. And I'd say when when I moved to Austin, it was like about 7 years ago. Of course, one of the things Austin's known for is what, food.
Oh yeah.
So I would go and try all these different food places. And I'm like, this is amazing. I would take photos. And my fiance actually was the one who was like, you should post it somewhere other than Instagram. You should do something more. And I was like, oh, okay, I guess. Of course, I was like, whatever.
Yeah. let's see how that goes. Yeah.
So then finally I'm like, you know, why not? So yeah. I started ATX FYI, and I was like, it's just a me thing. I'm just gonna start a website. You know, it's not expensive to have a website and write on it and everything. So I started that, and I just kept writing about things and my experiences and posting photos. And before you know it, people liked it, you know? Yeah. So I would just share with friends, and they'd be like, what do I do whenever I go to Austin? Where do I eat? Where do I not go?
Yeah, that's what I always do, because when I'm in Austin and everything, so I'm like always looking at videos on Instagram. I'm like, where should I go?
Yeah.
So yeah, and I'm so happy we met each other in Ensenada, and you gave me some tips and everything, and I'm so happy that, and I'm so grateful that my grandma opened the food truck, because that made me experience more people, and they gave me the little push to have my own Instagram and try. Ready? Let's go get an order.
Let's do it.
Oh, that looks like pink. My favorite color is pink. Favorite part about when the food comes, taking videos and pictures, am I right?
Exactly. And we go eat different places, and I'm like, okay, we take photos first
and
add some video.
A taco already.
And then you wait, and then he's like, I don't want to wait. I'm hungry now. I'm like, just wait. And then it's funny because over the years, invited to go to different places to try different things and food for free. So now he's like, okay, I'll wait. It's fine. You know, if I'm getting free food, I have no issue with that. He's learning, you know? Sometimes I just have to learn. But
yeah, because imagine this. You're like, okay, I'm going to take a picture, and you just turn around for 1 second, like 10 seconds,
yeah.
And there's a bite of the taco.
No.
And then you look back, and you're like, what happened to the taco? Now, all of the tortillas are colorful. Don't you think?
Yeah, they're so pretty.
Like, if you put all of these together, it's like a rainbow.
It's so pretty. They do great with presentation.
Yes. So are you ready to try? Nota, baby, chota.
Cheers.
Cheers. That's flavorful, but good.
And then what I love about their barbacoa is that it's not super greasy. Like, I've had some barbacoa that's very greasy.
Yeah.
Instead, it's just like perfect balance.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
Did it happen with you when you were little? Like, when you were little, you did not like avocado, but then when you grew up, like,
yes.
You love avocado now?
Yes. It started with guacamole, so I had to have that, and then I was taught, oh, those are in guacamole. You should like it. And so I was like, oh, okay, maybe. So now I love avocado.
My first time, but it's so good.
So good.
Now I'm gonna get green chilaquiles. What's your favorite part about the whole chilaquiles?
My favorite part? The barbacoa.
Me too.
Second, probably the corn chips.
Me is the avocado, and then third the corn chips.
It's all really good, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Your favorite meal is like, if you have one meal for the rest of your life.
Oh, that's easy.
That's easy.
First off, with and queso fresco and salsa macho and avocado. That's mine. What will be yours?
That's so hard. You're not supposed to spin it back on me. there's this restaurant called Columbia, and it's in Ybor City, and so which is near downtown Tampa, and it's like it's the oldest restaurant in Florida, Cuban place to go to, and so Cuban Spanish, and so I mean, like I think I could live off their arroz con pollo. Like, it's just so good.
So it's just like rice with pollo?
They have. It's usually like a quarter or half of a chicken, on the bone.
So we are done eating, right, Bianca?
Yes.
We're so done, and we are so full. We cannot eat a dessert.
Amazing.
Right. thank you guys so much for watching. My friend and me, Bianca. Now we're gonna go say bye to the sisters and the brothers. So let's go, Bianca. Thank you so much for everything, gracias. It was amazing. We are so full from everything. Thank you so much for this amazing food. This is the Santa Barabacha. Amazing, look how our photos came out. My favorite one was the last one because we were prepared. This one kind of, and this one we not weren't so prepared. We were not. We were like, I loved it, and thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much for watching Bianca and me together. Don't forget to follow me and give a like, and don't forget to follow Bianca.
At ATXFYI.